make proper introductions at this time.
As he told you, we're masters touch from right over there, Oakland City, and we're sure glad to be here. And the kids are excited about this, and they're a little anxious. We got a couple new things we just learned, and we're trying to get out on you. And we're called Master's Touch mainly because we hope that something we do, something the puppets say, something the minds express, through that maybe the Master can touch you. Maybe you can see a new insight in his love for us. And the first one we're starting off with is a little one called He Loves Me. And I hope everybody likes a little bit of rap because it's got it in it. So I want you to pay close attention to Leroy and the mimes as they show us He loves me.
Of the vision to see, hold tight day and night beyond the point of a dream.
she learned that she doesn't have to worry. All she has to do is trust Jesus.
Thank you.
only once that it takes 13 praises to make up for one criticism. Just imagine. We say that everyone should be able to accept constructive criticism, right? This is true, but there's a limit to the amount of reconstruction that's necessary. Perhaps we need to learn to offer criticism more selectively and not worry so much about the insignificant things. As you watch the happy clown, she was so happy. She was so excited just about a plain piece of paper and a marker. But at the end, it wasn't happy anymore, was she? The next puppet skit is one called Count Your Many Blessings. And how many know that song, Count Your Many Blessings? Oh, wait, I don't think you know this one. So hang on, it's really pretty. I like it. And as soon as they're ready. Yeah, they're out there. Not very loud, though, are they? I guess it's because they're in church.
Yeah.
She likes this next number. She likes it because it's kind of like rock and roll. So You might recognize the tune, but believe me, the words are changed, right?
Yeah.
What do you call it?
The rock medley.
Of course, because it's got a lot of rock songs on it. So I guess we could call it rock and roll, so let's let it roll. They didn't run. They remembered the jailer. So let's listen to I will praise the Lord.
Some men started swearing.
going to do this. I'm going to interview him.
This is the first time I've done this.
Okay. No, they're scared, aren't you? Okay. You want me to do this, guys?
Yeah. No, none of them do.
You're speechless, right? Okay. They're nervous. Okay. All right. I won't interview them. I'm going to someday, though. Okay? These guys wanted to go to the quartet convention a few weeks ago. Some people were lucky enough to get to go. But they wanted to go really bad, and if they'd have known that y'all were going, they'd have been with you. Because they really wanted to go and show those quartets down there how to really sing a song. The song they're going to sing next is called The Great Pretender, and we all remember the one from way back. Well, let me tell you, this song, first time I heard it, it almost made me cry. Because we can mess around in our Christian life and pretend until it's all over, and it's too late. So I want you to listen closely to the words as the master's quartet sing for us, The Great Pretender.
Oh yeah, I'm the great pretender. See you.
dreamed I went to heaven. You were there with me. We walked upon the streets of gold, beside the crystal sea. We heard the angels singing, and someone called your name. I turned and saw this young man, and he was smiling as he came. He said, "Friend, you may not know me now." Then he said, "But wait, you used to teach my Sunday school, and I was only eight. Every week you would say a prayer before the class would start. One day when you said that prayer, I asked Jesus in my heart. Change. Thank you.
times come to give them to the Lord. That's what this song to me is for. That's what this song to me is for. You don't have to carry those burdens anymore. There's a light in the darkness. There's a love that's true. That's what this song is for. That's what this song is for.
You'll notice the girls, when they're up here, they have the white faces on. We could pantomime without the white faces, but it wouldn't be nearly as effective because you would see them as individual people, and that's who they would be, their own personalities. But we put on the white face so that we're no longer the person that walked through the door. We're somebody totally different. 2 Corinthians 5:17, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things become new. The markings on their face, each one has picked out the markings they want to use, the markings that will express the way they feel right now, the way the song makes them feel, the character they're portraying. So each marking has a specific meaning. Our goals and our purpose in doing this is not just to have fun. The girls enjoy it, but I'll tell you why. After you've done it and done it so much, you get kind of tired from that main part. You know, it gets to be a little bit more than just fun. It's more of a ministry. First and foremost, what we want to do is glorify God in what we do. We're not doing it just for fun or entertainment. The second, we want to serve as ministers of the gospel through this creative form of expression. Thirdly, we want to reach all the people that we can, inside and outside the church. And we can do this through the message of mine to show God, to show Christ's hope and his love. If you'll notice, if you've ever been where there has been any pantomime going on and in a crowd of people of different ages, we have everyone's attention. The little children are on their parents' lap watching, and sometimes even doing the motions that are repeated several times. And it's fun. They're expressing themselves too. And as you watch what's going on, you retain what the message of the song is about. I mean, you've listened to the song, you thought, I didn't know what the song was about. Would you play it again, you know? Sometimes you have to hear it over and over again before you catch what it means. But when you see it performed, then it sinks down deep, and you catch a message maybe you missed. So I'm rambling on, give the girls a chance to catch their breath, and I want to introduce each one to you. Cut? Go on, okay. They do this to me all the time. Okay, girls, I want to introduce you one by one, okay? Tiffany Fisher, would you step through the door? Okay, come on. Amy Boleyn? You're getting a side view and a rear view, but you'll see them. They're a little shy, but I'll tell you what, once you get that makeup on, you can do anything. Christy Grummet. And Jennifer Chapman. Okay, we're going to begin, and we'll probably take it from one song right into another, unless I feel like we need a break, okay? So you won't get to hear my pleasant voice again, unless I know y'all are broke. The first song we're going to do is one, I've got a young girl that sings it for us, but she was unable to get here, so I'm going to sing it, and so bear with me. The song you've heard probably on the radio, From a Distance, everyone has heard that one. It was very popular when the war was going on. Desert Shield was over there and everything. We changed the last verse just a little bit. So I want you to just enjoy this, okay? Each song, I hope, will speak to you.
Thank you.
master commanded his family to soul in order to pay him back. And the servant cried, please be patient, I'm ready to pay you again. The king was moved with compassion, forgave him and canceled his debt. So
I have forgiven you. I can imagine.
And I want to tell the girls I appreciate them taking the time to come out here tonight. I really do. And we appreciate you guys giving us a chance to rehearse again.
Even though maybe what I was doing.
And thank you very much.
Well, we're trying to figure out this.